Hello friends. If you've ever done lots of work with CSS, you've probably broken stuff up into nice little files to make them nice and manageable, a bit like this. So I've got my buttons file here, and if I was to go into here, I've got all my stylings for my buttons, which is really nice. And then in my framework, if I was to quickly view the source, look at the CSS it's compiled. Oops. It's kind of just compiled it all into one big CSS file, which is wonderful. However, as you kind of start adding more and more things, this becomes pretty tedious to update. And I'm one of those people who definitely likes to kind of organize these in alphabetical order as much as I can. And the trick I'm going to show you is this post CSS import ext glob library, which allows you to import these files using a glob format like this. Okay, let me show you how to set this up. So we need to add it to our current project. My current project is a Bridgetown one, so I already have these available to me. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy the name of the library to my clipboard. I'm going to turn off my server, and I'm going to type yarn add-d and add in the library name there. Awesome. Let's have a look at what this changed. Drag this up a bit. So we can see it's changed our package.json and our yarn lock. So let's have a look at what changed in our package.json. So we can see it's added in the package we wanted, along with moving a package I added earlier to the right alphabetical place, which is nice. Cool. Let's tidy up this little file here. So I'm going to just change these folders because I want them to be imported in a specific order. I'm just going to put that little star in and do the same here and here and here as well. That looks better already. I like that. So if we were to turn this on now, I think we've also got to change those imports to be at glob. So import-glob. I think it's going to throw an error, or at least not render correctly. Let's just have a look at what that does. So I've missed a step, and I missed it on purpose because this threw me off the first time I did it, and I want everyone to kind of learn from my mistakes. Okay, we can see it's doing stuff, and yeah, it's rendered the CSS successfully. But we can see it's not rendered it in our browser. So let's have a look at our code here and see what's just happened. Okay, we can see it's just doing what we've put into here. So what we've missed, or what I've missed, is I have to edit my postcss.config.js to include this bit here. So in the most recent version of postcss, you add the plugins in here, and you just kind of add the name of the plugin surrounded by quotes with little curly brackets afterwards. We can see Bridgetown has now kind of seen that changed and reloaded our page. And there it is. So that's really fantastic. So that's all now working. And if I was to have a little look at the source code again, you can see it's imported everything. So that's super nice. I just wanted to share that because that's made my life so much easier. Like that, I think, is such a way more easier way to import lots of files. And if I added like anything in, maybe a new file, I might have to restart my server, but that's it. I won't have to sit there maintaining this file anymore. So that's all there is for today. I'd highly recommend giving this a quick look. I think there's something similar in SAS as well for using Rails, but if not, if using PostCSS, definitely give this library a look. Thank you so much, and I will see you next time.